Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Zach Lone Hunter, and welcome to Episodes. Now, I said we were going to do The Teacher. Here's the problem. No one told me who wrote it. But, I have two versions written by the same author, and they're the top two, most viewed, I guess? I don't know how to say it. Yeah. So, we either got this one, which has three new chapters of something, I don't fucking know. He's a teacher, she's a student. Will Mia be able to resist his charms despite having to live with him for years? Now the bonus art scene show in episode 44, 45, and 46. Or, we have this one, which is the teacher complete classic. A forbidden love, a love. Will Mia be able to make the right choices and find true love? I'm guessing it's the other one. I mean, it's made by the same person, but I'm guessing it's this one. So, yeah, because this one's most read, too. Look at that. 30.6 million reads. Everybody has been reading this fucking series. So, I'm going to take my chances on this one, since it's the most read one, and someone actually requested this one. Is it good? Maybe. Will I probably like it? No. Will it be a lot of episodes? Fuck. Yes. 46. Holy shit. That's going to be the rest of my damn, like, that's the rest of the year for me. Fuck it. I'm down. Do this shit. I hope there's no music though. Oh yeah. By the way, just in case there is a time where I got to use music, it's going to be the same music. It's not going to be different music because it's a different, story. That's the music I got. It's the music I'm using, so that's what you're gonna get. So, in case people start saying, oh, this fucking can't be good. Wait, the story was good. Ooh, hello. In our community? Oh, okay. Wait, it's made by an actual, like, community person? Oh. Please use your headphones. From the authors who brought to you Valentine's Day, Jungle Love,
Dreamland,
Dreamy Fatals. Okay, this is professional.
We now give you a new, improved The Teacher Season 1 Lessons of Love, Chapter 1.
Hey, I like the work that's put in this. Goddamn. Wait, do I have to make my own chick or chick sorry? Okay. Fancy ass house. 1501. Cool. Is that who I'm playing as? I guess so. So I guess I have to use my regular voice. 150 Hydrangea Lane. I don't know how to say that fucking word. Fuck y'all. Even though school was more than enough work for me, I needed a job.
Badly.
I knew I could kiss college goodbye if I didn't find one soon. God damn it, give me a sec. Sorry, family coming in. So where were we? I knew I could kiss college goodbye if I didn't find one soon. God fucking motherfucking damn! Sorry for the little inconvenience that motherfuckers heard, because dear lord, my goddamn family. Just all day, even when I was recording To the Moon. Yeah, that's right, I did To the Moon. Fucking lord, just all damn day, they've just been fucking walking in and out, and it's just, ooh, fuck. Okay. So, I've got fucking damn it. Not like a go-go today! Give me water. Okay.
I got my voices ready.
I know I could kiss college goodbye if I didn't find one soon. It must be this one. Wow, look at this place. It's huge. This is me. My name is Mia, and this is my story. Okay, cool. What's your story? Oh, okay. Knock, knock, knock. Cool. Okay. More knocking. Weird. There should be someone home. Nah, fuck it. What's gonna knock again? Fuck it. No. I'll take a look at the garden then. Oh, yeah. My choices matter. My choices. Who the fuck is that? Excuse me! And so I applied for a job as a nanny and had an interview with a woman named Mrs. Collins. Wait, what the fuck? Why is it called the teacher then? Okay.
Are you alright?
She asked while looking at her sense of... What? Sniffleroses. Yeah, exactly. The interview was today, right?
Yeah, today.
I felt awkward standing there talking to her back. This is actually very weird. I don't actually like this shit. You have to read a lot. Good, that's some pretty roses you got there.
Thank you, Mia.
She carefully caressed one of her hands as she sighed.
I was just checking out at one last dab. I will be leaving soon after all.
Oh, Bobby's moved. That's thing. That's new.
Look at me getting all sentimental now.
She was a small woman, very petite and very stylish, stylishly dressed. Okay. She looked perfectly polished and her skin was glowing, looking, goddamn, how many times are you gonna brush it? Looking healthy and clean. She definitely, oh dear lord, stop brushing. She definitely looked younger than she probably was. Only, my fucking god, she's, it's ticking me off. Oh dear lord. Okay, only a few curls, feet around her eyes and mouth. Okay, quit, please. Gave away that she had a lot of years with smiles and laughter behind her. Dear lord. She was a good looking woman and I could easily tell she enjoyed taking care of herself. Okay, I understand what you're doing, making it seem like it's a book, but technically, you have an advantage here. You don't have to... Well, then again, I guess you do, because there was a lot of hiccups with Bad Boys Girl that I called out at the end. But you know what? It's a damn series. Who the fuck cares? Okay.
I'm only Singapore for a year to take care of my mother who's ill.
A year? I see. I'm sorry.
Thank you, my son Dale just got a job here in town so he could be with Kylie. Kylie, he won't have much time for her because of his job, but he'll live here through. So, anyway, let's go inside and talk things over.
Sounds good, let's do this.
Like to meet Kylie too.
I'd love to.
Good, follow me. Meh, 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 meh.
Okay. Whew, you got this, Mia. I don't have to add shit! Holy fuck, I love this! God damn, it's a big ass house then!
Colin! Could you please come down here for a second? Just follow me, dear!
Okay. Da 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 da. Well, that's cool, I didn't know they could do that. The mansion was huge. I've never seen a house this magnificent before. Wait, so that means if they walk right there, will the couch be small? I don't know. Being in such a fancy place only contributed to my nervousness. I didn't have much experience with children. I'm an only child and have only babysat. How fucking loud is this, to be honest? That explains it. There we go. Some kind from the neighborhood a few times before I knew this was a long shot. Okay. I think I fucked that up. Okay.
Da 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 da! She should be down in a minute. Would you like something to drink, like alcohol or beer?
No thanks. I'm good. I just grabbed the coffee on my way here.
Ah, there she is. Me, 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 me. There you are, sweetie.
A black-haired girl with big blue eyes, dressed in an equally blue dress with polka dots, walked in. I'm gonna be honest, she looks like a... She looks like Alice. Like, I don't know if you guys seen the game, but Alice in Madness or some shit like that. PewDiePie played it for one thing, and he actually made a good joke about it. I'm not gonna say it now because it's sort of offensive, but still, she looks like that type of Alice. Her hair was braided, she had freckles crossing her nose on to her cheeks, and her skin was fair and radiant. She was such a beautiful young girl.
I want you to meet Mia, she's one of the few girls I'm considering to be your nanny.
Nice to meet you, Kylie.
Great a nanny, Mom, really? You fucking serious?
Oh shit, you talk exactly like her.
Kylie, don't start with me, we talked about this already. Yeah, and I see that diddy water diddy that I'm old enough to take care of myself, bitch!
Slut.
No, Kylie, you're 13. What would you expect to eat when I'm gone? Dale got home late and you can't cook. And what about laundry, cleaning, God? And not to mention your homework. You need nanny daddy. No, I don't need you. I don't need a daddy. I don't need anybody. Leave me alone. Ah! Kylie, please, are you fucking serious? Can you leave me alone? Oh, fucking Lord.
I'm sorry about that.
No, I'm sorry. I gave birth to that little shit. Oh, me, it's not your fault. Like I said, I fucking gave birth to that little shit. She hasn't been herself since I told her I was leaving because, you know, she's a little shit. That's why her hair's black. What? I think it's brown? Oh, fuck, it's just black. It's just like black as shit.
It must be hard on you all.
Nah, it's pretty good. I mean, it is, but my mother needs me now. She's incredibly stubborn. She's determined to die in Singapore.
What? Okay. I understand. Why don't we talk about everything when things calm down a bit? Okay, let's turn this shit up. There we go.
No, I'm fine. I'm sorry, dear. Let's move on to the interview. Let me just get my bed.
Okay, whenever you're ready.
Okay, Mia. You're 18, correct?
Correct. I'm turning 19 soon, though. And, real quick, where the fuck's your notepad?
Do you have an experience with babysitting?
Only a little. I've babysat some of the kids from my neighborhood a few times, you know what I mean?
Okay, what would you say is your greatest quality?
Fuck. Shit. I guess fast learning. Fuck it. I guess I'm a fast learner.
Oh, wonderful trait to have. Why do you want this job?
I'm saving up for college and I really like kids, so I thought this would be perfect for me.
Very well. Do you consider yourself a responsible person?
Fuck yeah. Very much so, Mrs. Collins. I've always told. Always been told I've done a good job with the kids I've babysat. And that I am very mature for my age. I'm also a proud straight A student.
Wow, that's total bullshit. You're trying to kiss my ass?
Maybe.
Oh, you went that way.
Fuck yeah.
Very impressive, Mia.
God damn it.
Let's go upstairs.
Okay. We continued the interview for another half an hour. Oh. And I thought everything went smoothly. I got the feeling that Mrs. Collins thought so too, but again, I knew this was a long shot. So I didn't want to get my hopes up.
Thanks for coming, Mia. I'll call you next week, okay?
Sounds good. Thank you, Mrs. Collins.
Bye, Mia.
Bye. We'll do this again next time.
Fuck yeah, just tell me and I'll be over here. Well, not really. I mean, I'll be in Singapore, but...
I'll be waiting.
I know, me too.
Dear Lord, I need help. Is it? There are two songs playing at once. Now, for the worst part.
The waiting.
Yep. What a day. Give me the water. What the fuck's with... Oh, okay. The following Monday. There they are, the two of my favorite people in the world. My boyfriend, Jake. He's not really my boyfriend. But we've had something going on since our freshman year. Nothing too serious, though. And this is my best friend, Kelly, or Kels, as I so creatively call her. Me and Jake's first year together went along smoothly. We were playful and very much in love. But our sophomore year had been rough. I started feeling more and more like we were going apart. I just refused to accept it. Someone's happy to see me.
Ah ha ha ha! Hi, bud.
Hey.
Mia, guess what? Kelly.
Oh, Kelly has been my best friend since kindergarten. I can't imagine life without her. What's up, Kels? It felt like that was, like, not really needed at that moment. She probably should have put that, like, when you were introducing her.
No, seriously, guess!
Oh, dear Lord. You got your period. Someone thought you were Emma Stone again. You found a cure for cancer.
You found a cure for cancer!
Next month. You want to guess again?
Sure. You got your period. You got your period, which means you and Nick got lucky again.
Yes, but no. You wanna guess again?
Yes! Someone thought you were Emma Stone.
Someone thought you were Emma Stone again.
No, but that was awesome. Thank you for reminding me.
You want to guess again? Oh my god, I already guessed all my choices. No. No, just tell me already. Goddamn.
Okay, you're not going to believe it.
Mrs. Hobbs finally retired.
No fucking way.
Not my detention for yawning iron. Hopefully.
Why do you talk like Arnold?
I don't know.
Okay, well, you guys haven't considered the chances of us getting someone even worse than Mrs. Hobbs.
Oh, please, no one is worse than Mrs. Hobbs, the grumpy old hag. Well, I guess we'll...
I guess we'll find out in about 5 minutes.
Millie! Guess what? Ma!
Hey, I am beautiful.
Stop it. Jake was my first.
What?
I was honestly worried about our future together.
Wait, like first, you know, thing, or like first thing?
I think you gotta be very, you know, specific about that shit.
Some reason I'm thinking it was a thing.
Why does he look like a tad blonde-haired Cole that actually was not a bad boy?
Cole, is that you?
A tall, tan, messy-haired guy walked through the door, now leaving the entire classroom dead silent.
Who was this guy?
I think he's obviously the teacher.
Note, you've unlocked a special scene.
Play special scene. Whoa, okay.
He has a mesmerizing, absolutely jaw-dropping, gorgeous. His dark eyes were elevating the room. This guy looked like he was taken straight out of a Hollywood romance movie.
Can you, no more zooming in, please.
His hair was perfectly swept to one side with hair gel that made up the color seem darker than it was. Speaking of dark, his eyes were so dark that almost seemed black. It made him look so mysterious. He had a masculine, sharp, extremely attractive jawline and equally attractive cheekbones. he was wearing a bluish shirt with a tight vest on top of it, showing off his broad shoulders and slim waistline. He was the definition of perfect. He looked over at me, gazing hopelessly at him. And I almost didn't believe my eyes when I saw the hint of a smile emerging from on his lips. While he playfully lifted an eyebrow at me. Oh yes. He totally caught me with my eyes and mouth wide open.
Ooh, sorry.
Could he really be our new teacher? Why would a guy like him teach at Woodstock High School? He grabbed a book from his bag, similar to our way to boy mathematics books. Now, there was no doubt in my mind, this was our new math teacher. This was Mrs. Hobbs' replacement.
Is that the end?
Oh my goodness, I think I'm going to faint. Hello! There's no way he's our new teacher. We can't be that lucky, can we?
The boys looked clearly annoyed as the girls started to giggle and whisper about him. Obviously.
Hi guys! My name's Mr. Collins. I'm your new math teacher. Yeah.
At the time, his last name, Collins, didn't ring a bell. Boy, was I in for a shocker. Shocker.
As you probably know, Mrs. Hobbs has retired. So please turn your pages 344.
Oh yes, Mrs. Collins, everything for you. Can it be quiet? He might hear you. Besides, he's probably married and have 4 kids.
What? No, he's not that old. He can't be more than a 5 year old, or 5 years older than us.
Besides, I could not care less.
He's dreaming.
Look at him, Mia.
He's somebody attractive.
I was feeling the exact same excitement as Kelly was about our new heartthrob as a teacher. But Jake was sitting right across the room from the corner of my eye. Okay. I could see him watching me, scared to see his reaction similar to Kelly's and the other girls. I didn't want to upset him, so I tried my best to stay as cool as possible. But as Mr. Collins turns around, reaching for his book, our eyes met once again. He held his eyes at me for a few seconds before looking down into his book, smiling to himself. On the outside, I remained calm, but on the inside, he just set me on fire.
This girl is on fire!
Sorry. How could our principal hire a man so good looking? How are we supposed to focus on learning now? What the fuck?
Okay, yeah, just cut it somewhere else. That makes sense. I was just about to enter Café La Me. Oh, Café La? Me and Kelly's favorite place to hang out at the school. But my phone rang. Ah, shit. Shut the fuck up. No one wants to hear this shit. Yo! God damn it. Hello!
Hello, me and this Mrs. Collins. I'm calling you for your little offer.
Okay, I need to stop. Okay. Oh, Miss Collins, how are you?
To be honest, I'm not feeling so good, Mia. I'm very stressed out at the moment. Yeah, time to stop by.
I was just on my way to get a coffee with a friend. I'll just let her know I won't be coming. I can be with you in 20 minutes, Mrs. Collins. Is that okay?
It's perfect. Thank you, Mia. I'll see you soon. You know, we can have some fun again.
Oh, yeah, see you soon.
Dear Lord, why did I do this?
I wondered what that was about. She sounded very upset. There was definitely more to it than her just wanting to tell me I'd get the job face to face. Something was bothering her a lot. Oh well, at least I was prepared for bad news after that call.
Oh, it's you again. Hello, Mia dear. Thank you for coming.
Of course, Mrs. Collins. How are you doing?
Oh, please call me Ellie.
I'll call you anything you want.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay, Ellie. So how's Kylie doing?
That's actually what I want to talk to you about. Please follow me.
Oh, okay. She moved gracefully towards the living room, gesturing me to follow her. I was getting mixed signals about this. Why would she ask me to call her Ellie if I was never going to see her again? Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Oh, then you know she fucking got hired. Duh. Ah, fuck, her voice hurts. Okay.
So, Mia, you saw Kylie back the last time you were here, so she is not doing well.
Well, I'm sorry. It's because I'm black, isn't it? Actually, are you black? You could be like a light tan black. I don't know. I'm probably confused.
She refuses to talk to me and she won't come out of her room.
I see.
Therefore, I decided to make you an offer that will benefit you. But Kylie very much as well. And I really hope you will consider this offer.
Yeah, what up?
I will not only offer you the job, Mia. I'll pay you triple the amount of money per day than what was offered in my ad.
Whoa, really?
But only if you will live here and take care of Kylie the year I will be gone.
Wait, what? You want me to live here?
Fuck yeah!
What? What? Is that it? Are we done? Oh shit. Oh shit, I think we're done. To be continued. Damn. That's pretty good length. If you like this story, support the author by sharing it. I did actually add it to my favorites because I wanted to, you know, have it right there near it. I'm gonna be honest, it's pretty cool. It's new. It shows that a lot of work was actually put into it. Because it had its own music, had its own crap. Even Bad Boys Girl didn't have that, and it wasn't even made by someone that works with goddamn episodes. It was made by an actual creator. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this series. Let's see if it goes better. I hope I found the right one, because I don't know if this is actually the right one. So, yeah. I will see you guys in the next episode of The Teacher. Bye, guys.